In the merchandise, of course, do you know the archetypal story about George Lucas bought the rights and the guy who sold them to him is in a concrete pillar in in LA, which, because they were immense, I mean, well, what's it been, 40 years of merchandising, which virtually created merchandising, and that they've changed considerably from day one to today, in that today's are incredibly sophisticated, brilliantly produced and manufactured, and very varied, as indeed is the fan art. I mean, a lot of the posters and a lot of the artwork is just delightful now, and you'd want to own. 40 years ago, not so much. You didn't really want to own too much. But I do get sent bits and pieces from time to time. Thank God, Hasbro. Yes, I love you, Hasbro. They send me a few bits and pieces and Funko and all that sort of stuff. So I have a little attic at home which has a few sort of special bits and pieces, as indeed some of the stuff that the fans do, which is tremendously talented now, and so we do keep a few bits, and every so often my wife says that's got to go and that's got to go. The funniest bit I ever had was had a knock on the door from the postman. I live in Dorset in a rural village, and postman was there with a package this big, and it was the head of Greedo, which was about that big, from an American company, and I had no idea what to do. In fact, it's still in my attic to this day. I was going to put it on the roof, but I couldn't get it up there. You know, like the guy had the shark on his roof in Clapham. Well, I was going to have Greedo's head just sort of leaning over from... I don't think my neighbours would have liked that too much. But yeah, so I do keep one or two odd bits. I did. It's a fairly well-known story now, but I did keep the gun that I used in the original scene, which was unusual because in the 1970s there was nothing from a movie you wanted. It was all junk. You couldn't wait to leave, basically. So, but the guns were great. The little guns that the props department had used in most of the first movie. All our handguns were German Mausers, which had little bits of plastic put on them to make them look like space guns. And I liked mine. I thought I'd take that for my kids, who were very young. So I gave it to one of the boys when he was about three, and he played with it for about a year. And then he snapped the plastic bit that they glued on off the front off. So I threw it in the bin. Do you know how much? That gun would be, it's the second most iconic gun in all space history. There's only Han Solo's, which is more iconic, really. And I threw their private education in the bin. So that I do regret that, of all the merchandising.